Good morning, students. Yesterday we talked about economy and central problem of economy, what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. Today the next topic is production possibility curve, that is also known as by frontier curve or transformation curve. So we will learn that. So what is TPC curve basically? Yeah, transformation curve, yeah, frontier curve. All of them are different, but everything is same. What it says, it is graphical representation of production possibility schedule. Schedule means combination. It can be a graphical representation. Here we have shown here a graphical representation. So there are some assumptions before we are going to start that. We should learn about some assumptions in that. So resources are given. And the second is given resources are fully and efficiently utilized. And third is technology remains constant. These are assumptions. All the resources, whatever the resources it is, that should be given. And given resources are fully and efficiently utilized. And technology remains constant. As we know before, if we want to go for the production, so there is input. Input is like if we want to produce something, we need land, labor, capital, that is input of production. So we are having the production that one. So here we will see here, there is one table here. Like here we have the given the resources, we have the land, one resources, 1 acre land we have. Just it is assumption. We want to produce in 1 acre apples and wheat. So if we will, all the resources we will use in given resources, then what will happen? 100 lakh tons we can produce apple only. All the resources if we use, maximum production can happen apples. If you will use maximum resources here in the graph also, if you use the maximum resources, we can use apples, we can produce apples 100 lakh tons. If you use total resources only for the production of wheat, then the maximum we can produce here 40 lakh tons. So in the same table we have shown in the graph representation, OX we have taken the wheat and the OY we have taken apples. So here there is different combination curve. Like here, if we produce only apples, maximum we are going to produce here 100 lakh tons. If you produce like only wheat in that resources, we can maximum produce 40 lakh tons. So if you want to produce like this and next wheat in the some land, if you want to produce, we want to produce for 10 lakh tons, like this side, 10 lakh tons of wheat, then what will happen? Like here, our production possibility goes down from here to here. Yeah? It will slash from top, it will come down. Now, like only 90 lakh tons we can produce in that resources at first only, because in the sun lands we are going to farm wheat only. In the second option, if you are going to if you want to increase the production of wheat, we are going to x-axis, that 20 lakh tons we are going to produce. Then this one will be slashed from 100 to 70 now. The C combination will come. Here we will produce like 70 lakh tons of apples now. And again, lastly, we have increased here the wheat. If you want to increase this same minus, then if you want to produce here 30 lakh tons, then it will come here 40 lakh tons. And if you want to produce here 40 lakh tons, then this will be 0. So what it shows, this combination shows, this schedule shows, here like any combination you can go for, there is A, B, C, D, E. All combination comes because resources are limited. In the given resources, you want to produce of same lands, what you want to produce, apples and wheat. So if you want to produce both of these, like in the if you want to go for the B combinations, then we produce here 10 lakh tons and this will be 90 lakh tons. If you want to produce here a bit more, it will be 20 lakh tons, then it will become 70 lakh tons. So if you are increasing this size, production of wheat, we want to increase, then automatically in this size, it will be slashing down, we will sacrifice some things of apples, because land and resources are limited, the same land we want to produce. So what shall I do? So here any combination we can choose that one, A, B, C, D, which one should be preferable, you can go for that one. So here if you want to study, we learn about what to produce and how to produce. What to produce means, in the same land, what to produce this option, apple or wheat. So this problem can be solved. The second is how to produce. Like how to produce means, if we produce labor intensive, our production possibility comes here, A to B. Like this is possibly production possibility. If one increase that possibility, what will happen if you like is what a technique we use of farming. There are possibly cut calamities from here to here because this was before here and this is seed. So we can, for production possibly can change by using the new technology and new new methods of farming. The second is our production possibly can increase when we are finding some new resources, like if we have some land and we found some new lands, yeah, some mines, some resources like we have like forest something, and you make new lands, that one. So resources are the same, so some new, if you find some new resources there, your production possibly goes up and definitely increase. So production possibly is always called, this is concave to the origin. Why it is concave to the origin? When we are increasing this side, x-axis we are increasing, production of wheat we are going to increase, automatically this will go down from that way. In the A combination it was 100 lakhs, in the B combination 90, then 70 is like slow comes down from top, that is for the concave to the origin. Yes, so there are some new things also like the running here. In this combination, you can see also that if we have these combinations, our production possibly can maximum, we can produce in that resources here, this is our PVC curve. If you want to produce here, it is not possible. This is called not attainable because all the resources we are using, that is limited. We cannot go. This is potential. Our potential is this is here, we cannot produce this one because our maximum production can be, our potential is here only, we can produce only. That is not attainable because our resources are given resources we are using and technology using is constant. The second is if you are utilizing here of our resources, our production is here, that means underutilization. We are doing that underutilization. It is not whatever resources we have, we are not using, it is certainly effectively done. So here in this chapter we learned about the production possibility. The production for how it is graphical representation and it shows like how combination we can go for. If you produce like can you put for the A1, commonly use apples. If you use the wheat of 10 lakhs, in the summer we go for the farming of wheat, then automatically it will go down. If we are increasing this side, increasing this side, that means all the combination A, B, C, D, E. So any combination we can go for that. So this is the production possibility. In the next chapter we will learn something. So this is lesson 1 and lesson 2 we have finished that. And I hope you can understand this and you can go through from your book. Okay, have a nice day.